So we have started with our unit one, that is cosmetic regulatory. Okay, so we are going to study how do you regulate the cosmetics. As I said, like drugs, cosmetics also should be regulated because safety aspect is very, very important. And hence the manufacturing regulation of the non-manufacturing, regulation of the selling, regulation of the labeling. Okay. Then regulation of the safety aspects, etc. Everything becomes very, very important. We don't want any misbranded, we don't want any spurious cosmetics to enter into the market, which may be harmful for the individual. Okay, hence regulation is a very important aspect when it comes to cosmetics. Then, in order to regulate a cosmetic, we should first know what are cosmetics, you know. Then that's why we have designed the cosmetics. Though your syllabus asks for definition of cosmetic as per India regulation, where there are four and four points which are very important, which talks about how the cosmetics are applied and the use for which the cosmetic has been done. Okay, that we have seen, and we have also seen the definition of cosmetics as per the European Union, which I feel is more complete, you know, which talks about the teeth, talks about the mucous membrane, which talks about the oral cavity, which talks about the cleaning, which talks about the hair system, nails, lips, etc. Okay, which also talks about the perfume, which is not talked about in your what call that in your Indian definition. Also, it talks about the deodorants, whereby it talks about the correction of the body odors, etc. So that's why I have taken the second definition as per the European Union also. Okay. Then we shifted our focus on about the import of cosmetics. Okay, you cannot import any cosmetic from outside. We talked about the what you call that manufacturing of cosmetics, regulation of it. We talk about the selling regulation, but it should not be that you are importing any substandard, spurious, or non-safe cosmetics and selling into India. That should not happen. That's why there is a regulation of cosmetics also. In that, we have seen that which are the cosmetics which should not be imported, which types of cosmetics are prohibited to be imported under Section 10. Those we have seen. Then we went on to see if you want to import the cosmetics, then which are the station, which are the ports, which are the airports through which only these cosmetics can be imported, because then you have the machinery over there which is going to take care of checking the safety of the cosmetics, etc. Okay, so that's why these cosmetics should be imported through these ports only. Then we went on to see that the cosmetics should comply Schedule Q and Schedule S. Schedule Q talks about the list of dyes, colors, pigments, etc. Okay, whereas Schedule S talks about the list of cosmetics which should have proper standards. Here there is a list of 36 cosmetics. Okay, so in Schedule Q also we have seen that there is part one and part two. Okay, part one, it talks about the dyes, colors, and pigments which are permitted to be used in cosmetics as well as soaps, whereas part two talks only about the soaps. Okay, this is a list of 36 cosmetics which should comply with your Schedule S standards. As I told you, Schedule S standards talks about the standards of cosmetics. Means your cosmetics should comply with the BIS standards. Okay, these are the Bureau of Indian Standards. Okay, IS standards. It should comply with that. What are these standards, etc., regarding Schedule S, we are going to see in the great detail at the end. Schedule Q, I have already shared you with the list of the dyes and colors which can be used in the cosmetics. Then we went on to see the what are the misbranded cosmetics which cannot be imported. So these are the cosmetics which are misbranded, these types of cosmetics, and they cannot be imported by you. Then we talked about the spurious cosmetics. So we talked about what are spurious cosmetics and what are the co and these are the cosmetics which cannot be imported by you. Okay. And finally, last time we saw rule 134A. This rule 134A talks about the coal tar colors. So in order to understand about the they say that no cosmetic shall be imported which contains coal tar color other than that prescribed in Schedule Q. सर शेड्यूल क्यू में जो भी कोल्टार कलर्स दिए हुए हैं दैट कैन बी एडेड टू द कॉस्मेटिक्स एंड देन दैट कॉस्मेटिक्स कैन बी इम्पोर्टेड. इफ देर सम अदर कॉस्मेटिक कंटेनिंग कोल्टार कलर देन दैट कैन नॉट बी इम्पोर्टेड. I gave you a disclaimer last time that when you say coal-tar color, actually these cosmetics, actually these colors are not coal-tar colors now. I told you what are coal-tar colors. Coal-tar colors are the byproducts from coal. These were the colors which were prepared earlier. Nowadays they are not prepared by these ways. They are prepared from petroleum. But however, these colors are known as coal-tar colors only. Okay, got it? So, but if you are importing these colors, then if you are importing these cosmetics, then the color should be added, which is prescribed as per in Schedule Q. Otherwise, you cannot, import these cosmetics. Moreover, these colors also, even if they are prescribed in Schedule Q, you have to take care that the amount of arsenic, that the amount of lead and the amount of heavy metals that are present in the Schedule Q colors also are limited. Okay. Otherwise, we talked in the second or third slide that how arsenic is lethal. We talked about how lead is lethal. We talked about other heavy metals, how they are lethal. We talked about mercury, how the most poisonous metal. Okay. We talked about that also. Okay. Just a minute. Theory out of 75. Theory is out of 75. No, no, no. Lecture with this one. Okay, sorry. Any objective? Huh? Nantra Bhutta. लेक्चर मध्ये म्हणून या सॉरी या नाउ लेट अस गो मूव अहेड विथ आवर सेकंड पार्ट. वी हैव सीन अबाउट द इंपोर्ट्स. नाउ लेट अस सी द रेगुलेटरी प्रोविजन फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक्स. सो इफ यू हैव टू इंपोर्ट द कॉस्मेटिक्स, यू नो व्हाट इज टू बी डन, व्हाट यू डोंट हैव टू इंपोर्ट, व्हाट यू कैन इंपोर्ट. इफ यू हैव टू इंपोर्ट, देन व्हाट आर द नॉर्म्स दैट शुड बी फॉलोड इन ऑर्डर टू इंपोर्ट. This is what we have studied up till now. We just have revised the previous lecture. Let us move further with the regulatory provisions for the manufacturing of cosmetics. So if you have to manufacture, then what? So if you have to manufacture, the first thing that is required is you have to have a license for manufacturing of cosmetics if you are intending it for sale or distribution. अगर आप कोई कॉस्मेटिक्स मैन्युफैक्चर करके खुद के ऊपर यूज करना चाहते हो तो आपको लाइसेंस लेने की जरूरत नहीं है. ओके, जस्ट फॉर एन इम्पॉर्टेंट, आई वॉन्ट टू अप्लाई अ हल्दी का फेस पैक एट ऑन माई फेस. सो आई हैव टेकन हल्दी, आई हैव टेकन व्हाट यू कॉल दैट मुल्तानी मिट्टी, देन आई हैव टेकन दैट एलोवेरा जेल फ्रॉम दी व्हाट यू कॉल दैट फ्रॉम दी प्लांट दैट आई हैव एट माई होम. And I mix it together and I've added milk to it and I have prepared a paste and I have applied to my face. So I have prepared a cosmetic actually. For that cosmetics where I have to use on myself, I don't have to take a license. But the same cosmetic I have prepared and I am selling it to Sakshi. Okay, Sakshi, because I was talking with Sakshi, so I have taken a name. So I'm selling it to Sakshi now. So if I have to sell it to Sakshi, then I have to take a proper license of manufacturing. And then only I can sell it to Sakshi. Otherwise, I cannot sell it to Sakshi. So a license is required for manufacturing. And this license is issued by your state regulatory authorities. That is your state FDA. So your state FDA is going to give you the license of manufacturing. And then only you can manufacture a cosmetics which you are intending for sale. Or you say that I'm not intending it for sale. I just want to distribute it. Even if you want to distribute it, then also you have to take a license, whether you have to sell or whether you have to distribute, right? And that license is given by your state regulatory authorities. Now, how you are going to obtain a license? Okay. In order to obtain a license, you have to fill an application. The form 31 is available. In that, you have to fill the application and then you are going to get the license on form 32. So on form 32 you will get the license, and you have to fill form 31 and submit it to the FDA. I'll just show you form 31 if you give me a few minutes. Okay, form 31. Yeah, so are you able to see, Sakshi?
Yes sir.
Okay, so this is form 31. This is application for grant or renewal. So even if you have to renew a license, then also this form you have to fill. If you want a new license, you're applying for a new license, then also this form you have to fill for. Of a license to manufacture cosmetics, if you're intending it for sale or for distribution. Okay. So here you have to write everything. So this is the license. You have to write on the name of the cosmetics. You have to write on the name of technical staff for manufacturing testing. And you have to pay a fees. Okay. And then you have to apply and you have to accompany something along with this form. Once you fill this form, attach the documents and give it, then you will get a license. That license will be issued in the form 32. Okay. So that is how it is going to be. Yes. Let us go again for our lecture. Yeah. So in this way, you are going to apply in the form number 31, which I showed you now. And the license will be given to you in the form number 32. That is the manufacturing license. If you are applying for loan license manufacturing, then you are going to apply in the form number 31A. And the license is going to give you in the on form number 32A. Okay. Can you just tell me what is a loan license? Somebody? Loan license manufacturing? Yeah.
Sir, it can be to, if you want to have an industry of our own, then for the loan purpose.
No. For the loan purpose, no.
Sir, it is a license owned by the another person, which gives the license to the other person for manufacturing.
Riddhi. But can you just modify
cosmetics which he do not own?
You're absolutely right, Riddhi. Absolutely right. Isko sirf Marathi ya Hindi mein bataoge?
म्हणजे ते लायसन्स आपण एखाद्या व्यक्तीकडून आपल्याकडे जेव्हा इंडस्ट्रीसाठी आपल्याला काहीतरी मॅन्युफॅक्चर करायचं आहे बट आपल्याकडे लायसन्स नाही तेव्हा आपण जेव्हा एखाद्या व्यक्तीकडून मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग करण्यासाठी लायसन्स युज करतो.
त्या व्यक्तीच्या लायसन्सच्या नावावर आपण मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग करतो.
त्या व्यक्तीच्या नावावर लायसन्सच्या नावावर आपण मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग करतो नाही. एनीबडी एल्स? लोन लायसन्स इज अ लायसन्स वेअर बाय आय एम हॅव्हिंग अ इंडस्ट्री, आय एम हॅव्हिंग अ मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग युनिट, आय एम हॅव्हिंग ऑल द इक्विपमेंट्स रेडी विथ मी, आय एम हॅव्हिंग रॉ मटेरियल, आय एम हॅव्हिंग माय पीपल, but I am going to manufacture it for Purva. Purva is going to sell, Purva is going to distribute, Purva is going to earn the profit on it. What Purva is just telling me, ki Mr. Vani, please manufacture these products for me and give it to me. So I am going to manufacture it. At supposing she tells me, Mr. Vani, manufacture cold cream for me. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I am going to manufacture cold cream at my place in my industry. Now, usme bhi bahut sara hai. Usme bhi kabhi kabhi Purva bol sakte hai ki sara chemicals mere honge, raw material mera hoga. Main aapko raw material provide karungi. Okay. Aap sirf usme conversion cost lena. Conversion cost yani converting the raw material into the finished product is conversion. Okay, so just take conversion cost from me. So that is also possible. Sometimes Purva may tell me that you only bring the raw material from your source and you only process it and give me the final product. ठीक है? कभी कभी पूर्वा मुझे कंटेनर भी देगी, पूर्वा मुझे लेबल भी देगी, पूर्वा मुझे रॉ मटेरियल भी देगी. ठीक है? पूर्वा मुझे जो केमिकल्स एनालिसिस के लिए लगते वो भी देगी। कभी कभी पूर्वा ये भी कर सकते कि पूर्वा बोल सकते कि मेरा एक पर्सन रहेगा जो तुम्हारी इंडस्ट्री में रहेगा और वो सुपरवाइज करेगा थिंग्स को। पूर्वा कैन डू दैट ऑल्सो। पूर्वा कैन डू वन मोर थिंग। पूर्वा कैन से यू मैन्युफैक्चर, मिस्टर वाणी यू मैन्युफैक्चर एज पर द प्रोसीजर एंड गाइडलाइंस विच आर गिवन बाई मी, एंड दैट प्रोडक्ट यू सेंड इट टू मी, आई विल इवेल्युएट एट माई लेवल। वैसा भी करते हैं। I will just tell you a classical case of Pfizer, okay, whereby I was in Litaka. When I started my work, I started my work with Litaka Pharmaceuticals. It was a Pune-based company. It was a Pimpri-based company. Okay, PCMC area mein aati thi wo. Litaka, because it was liquid tablet and capsule. Isliye Litaka, liquid tablet capsule. Wo teen formulations banate the. That was my first job, and I was manufacturing Picosul serum. Okay, that was my first product which I started manufacturing. Now this Picosul serum manufacturing, the raw material used to come from Pfizer. Okay, that time that product was with Pfizer. I don't remember now it is with whom now Picosul. I think so Pfizer has sold it or not, I don't remember. But I think so Pfizer sold that product because of it. But it was at that time with Pfizer. So what Pfizer used to do is, Pfizer used to send the raw material, whereas the packaging material was brought by Litaka themselves. Okay, so labeling and packaging was with Litaka. Wo material Litaka lati thi, khud ke paiso se. Theek hai? The raw material was processed into the final product. The final product ka jo quality assurance hai, okay, that quality assurance was done by the by our company, okay, quality assurance, that is Litaka. Whereas the quality control, the final product testing, used to be carried out by Pfizer. So what Litaka would require is, Litaka, this is about the drug, same thing happens for the cosmetics also. So what Litaka would require is, Litaka has to apply to the FDA in Form 31A, okay, to manufacture the products for others. So agar meri cosmetic company hai aur Purva ne kaha ki mujhe cold cream manufacture karna hai, to mujhe Form 31A mein FDA ko application dena padega ki mujhe Purva ke liye cold cream meri company mein manufacture karke usko deni hai. I have to submit it to her or sell it to her. Okay, that is the loan licensing. And the FDA would give me the license to manufacture Purva's drug, Purva's cosmetic, that is cold cream, in 32A. So 32A mein wo mujhe license de degi. Jab mujhe wo 32A mein license milega, then I can manufacture for Purva. Okay, am I clear? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sir, so yeah, we can take loan licenses for two or more than two companies or manufacturing for them?
You can take for 10 companies. Koi problem nahi.
Phir loan license same hi rahega phir, sir?
Kya
alag alag loan license same rahega ya phir se hame dusri company ki
liye karna hai? Har product, nahi nahi, har product ke liye aapko naya license lena padega.
Okay, sir.
और इन वन एप्लीकेशन यू कैन राइट डाउन 10 लाइसेंसेस. फॉर एग्जांपल पूर्वा ने अगर मुझे कहा कि सर मैन्युफैक्चर कोल्ड क्रीम, मैन्युफैक्चर मॉइस्चराइजिंग क्रीम, मैन्युफैक्चर एंटी एजिंग क्रीम एंड मैन्युफैक्चर सनस्क्रीन फॉर मी एंड गिव इट टू मी, देन आई हैव टू फिल एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म 31A जिसमें मैं सारे प्रोडक्ट्स लिखूंगा कि आई एम इंटेंडिंग टू मैन्युफैक्चर फॉर से पूर्वा की कंपनी है, पूर्वास कॉस्मेटिक्स. सो आई एम इंटेंडिंग टू मैन्युफैक्चर फॉर पूर्वास कॉस्मेटिक्स फॉलोइंग कॉस्मेटिक्स. And these are the, then it is not only कि मैं बोलूँगा कि मुझे manufacture करना है और मुझे manufacturing license मिल जाएगा, वैसे नहीं होता वो, ठीक है. Then I have to give them all the documents, whether I am having the facility, whether I have that area, whether वो आगे दिया हुआ है मैंने, whether that I am having that people, whether I am having that methods to manufacture, whether I am having that methods to evaluate that product, okay. Whether I am having proper source for raw material, आजकल बहुत सारी चीजें पूछते हैं, okay? Whether I am having that proper premises, सो दे विल आस्क फॉर एवरीथिंग. बराबर है ना. जस्ट फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, जस्ट फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, लिटागा ने बोला कि उनको रेमडेसिविर मैन्युफैक्चर करना है. क्यों, किसके लिए? सिप्ला के लिए. जस्ट फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग. वाई? बिकॉज रेमडेसिविर शॉर्ट नो. सो लिटागा इज सेइंग कि मुझे मैन्युफैक्चर करना है. बराबर है. लेकिन FDA, when they will come to the premises and they will check that there is no facility that is available to manufacture that kind of a product, they won't grant the license. Samajh mein aa gaya aapko what I mean to say? So it is not that you are applying and you are getting the license, but they are going to check whether you are having that proper facility or not. That we are going to see further. Yes, but answering your question, yes, you can go for a loan license for n number of companies. I can, if I am having the facility, I can go for loan licensing of Pfizer, I can go for Cipla, I can go for Ranbaxy, I can go for Reddy's at the same time, Alembic at the same time. Only I should have the facility. और दूसरी बात, इन लोगों ने मुझे permission देनी चाहिए manufacturing की. बराबर है ना. इनके साथ भी मेरा contract होना चाहिए. There are many manufacturing companies that are there in India which are only doing loan licensing work. Wo sirf dusre ke liye manufacture karke unko bech dete hain. They do only manufacturing, they don't do selling, they don't have their own products. There are many companies, okay, which are not manufacturing at all. They get it manufactured from somewhere else and they are just doing the selling of the product. Selling and distribution is carried out by them, whereas manufacturing is carried out by somebody else.
Sir, all this process is contract based?
All this process is contract based. Contract based in the sense, contract based matlab kya, do logo ke beech mein contract hota hai, that is contract based. So you have to enter into a contract. Matlab jaise purva tum mujhe boli ki cold cream manufacture karke do, मैं आपको ये दूंगी, मैं आपको ये नहीं दूंगी, आपको ये करना है, आपको इस तरह से करना है, आप आपके कंडीशंस रखोगे. उसके अगेंस्ट मैं बोलूंगा ठीक है, इसके लिए मैं आपको चार्ज करूंगा इतना इतना, दैट इज पर कंटेनर, दैट इज पर कोल्ड क्रीम आई विल बी चार्जिंग यू से 10 rupees. सो दैट इज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इन बिटवीन यू एंड मी.
यस
सर, एवरीथिंग इज प्रॉपरली बीन टोल्ड किस तरह से करना है.
Sir, and is it also same for the engineering companies also, which manufactures the different parts of the cars and two wheelers? They also take the loan license by the same process, or is it only for pharmaceuticals?
Is it a loan license over there, or is it spare part manufacturing and selling is something to be, you know, understood? That again would be a contract, but I don't know whether they call it as loan license or not in engineering. I frankly don't know. उसको वर्ड्स क्या यूज करते हैं, whether they are using the word as loan license or something else. But yes, that happens. You are absolutely right. The thing that you pointed out is absolutely right. जब टेलको बनाता है, ठीक है, supposing कोई भी, supposing मारुति लेते हैं अपन, जब मारुति कार बनाता है तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वो हर एक स्क्रू बनाता है. इतने 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 स्क्रू लगते हैं उसमें, हर टाइप के, हर पैटर्न के स्क्रू लगते हैं, सीट लगते हैं उसमें. तो सीट थोड़ी मारुति अपने कंपनी में बनाता है. डू यू थिंक मारुति प्रिपेयर्स सीट? नो
नो सर.
सीट कहां से लाते हैं वो? किसी और से परचेस करते हैं. बराबर है. सपोज़ वो इंजन बनाते हैं, तो इंजन में नंबर ऑफ स्क्रूज लगने वाले, वो खुद लेते बनाते क्या वो? नहीं.
नो.
कोई उनको बना के देता है. उसमें स्टीरियो सिस्टम लगता है, तो मारुति खुद स्टीरियो सिस्टम बनाता है? नहीं. There is somebody else who is preparing the stereo system for them. Speakers लगते उसमें, car में. Maruti बनाता है? No, they get it from somebody else. Right? There was a story, I don't know, many years back, you know, telco में strike हुआ था. Telco, those are from Pune and nearby areas, and you all also must be knowing telco is one of the biggest company in PCMC area. बराबर? तो टेलको में बहुत बड़ी स्ट्राइक हुई थी उस टाइम पे. मे बी दिस मस्ट बी 30 years back की बात है ये. ओके, आई वाज इन माय स्कूल और कॉलेज डेज एट दैट टाइम. टेलको में बहुत बड़ी स्ट्राइक हुई थी. तो इट इज सेड दैट जब टेलको में स्ट्राइक हुई थी, तो इट इज नॉट दैट ओनली टेलको वाज अफेक्टेड, apart from telco, there were thousands of companies which were in PCMC area. जिसको हम स्मॉल स्केल यूनिट बोलते हैं, ओके, SSUs, those small scale industries or SSIs or SSUs, these were also affected and they were thousand in numbers. क्योंकि इतने parts उनके पास जाते थे, ये छोटे-छोटे companies से उनको parts supply होते थे. अगर strike हो गया तो अगर उन्होंने अपना manufacturing बंद कर दिया, तो ये इन लोगों से भी parts नहीं लेंगे. तो these also companies got affected. Okay, are you understanding? So one company closing down is not just one company closing down. Uske saath saath thousands of companies are there which are getting affected. Okay, are you understanding? So yes, this coming back to your question. So yes, in engineering also this happens, but the only thing is the methodology is different. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes, but, sir.
वैसे भी एक pharma company अगर बंद हो जाएगी तो उससे भी बहुत अफेक्ट होता है. नॉट ओनली द वर्कर्स ओवर देयर, वो कहीं से लेबल लेते हैं, वो कहीं से कोरुगेटेड बॉक्सेस लेते हैं, वो कहीं से बॉटल लेते हैं, वो कहीं से रॉ मटेरियल लेते हैं, दे आर परचेसिंग दी, दे आर मेंटेनिंग दी एयर कंडीशनर्स, दे आर मेंटेनिंग दी एयर हैंडलिंग यूनिट्स एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. कितनी चीज़ें हैं, ट्रक्स है क्योंकि उनका माल ट्रक्स में आता है, ट्रक्स में जाता है. So there are many industries that are affected because of, you know, closure of one company. So बहुत लोगों को इसके ऊपर से affect होता है. Yeah. Coming back, so if you are, yeah, any other question you have?
Sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, yeah, when taking a loan license, is it necessary that the person who is taking the loan license has to be a registered pharmacist?
वो registered pharmacist नहीं हुआ तो भी चलेगा, लेकिन उसने he should employ a registered pharmacist.
That's yes. Right.
The person who is manufacturing it should be a registered pharmacist. The okay, person sir. Who is doing the quality control should be a registered pharmacist. Okay. That is very important. Right? So wo khud matlab supposing mujhe agar main registered pharmacist nahi hu aur mujhe agar dawai banane ki company kholni hai to main kar sakta. That I can do. अगर मैं रजिस्टर्ड फार्मासिस्ट नहीं हूँ और मुझे किसी और से दवाई बना के लेनी है तो मैं कर सकता हूँ, लेकिन जो बनाने वाला होगा, okay, the person who is going to sign the documents कि this batch is been prepared by me, वो जो document sign होगा, that document has to be signed by registered pharmacist only and nobody else. Okay, that is it.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any other question? Okay, thank you. Purva, you're saying something?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you guys for asking the question. These types of questions and answers really make the session very interesting, and the teacher also feels that he has contributed. Thank you. Please keep asking questions. Jo bhi knowledge I would like to share with you. Okay. Apart from application, along with the application, what you have to do is you have to pay some fees. ये फीस उस समय की है, नियर अबाउट 3-4 इयर्स बैक व्हेन आई प्रिपेयर्ड दिस स्लाइड्स, उस समय की है. ओके, द फीस एट दैट टाइम वाज 2500, आई थिंक सो नाउ इट इज मॉडिफाइड टू 3500 इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू हैव टू पे इंस्पेक्शन फीस ऑफ रुपीज 1000. ओके, इफ द नंबर ऑफ कैटेगरीज आर नॉट एक्सीडिंग टू 10. ओके, देन अलॉन्ग विद द एप्लीकेशन, एज आई सेड, एप्लीकेशन के साथ साथ उसको बहुत सारी चीजें देनी होती है. सो व्हाट आर द थिंग्स that he has to give the layout of the premises. Okay, he has to give the blueprint. So how his industry would look like. He has to give the list of equipments and machineries. So what are the equipments and what are the machineries that are required, okay, to be there inside the plant. Okay, that we are going to see under schedule M, maybe in my next lecture. Okay, then along with that, he is also going to give you, he has to also give the constitution of the firm, that who is going to be the MD, who is going to be the CEO, who is going to be the treasurer, who is going to be the financer, and so on and so forth. Constitution of that firm ka. So he has to give the constitution. Jaise abhi aapka ban raha hai, isn't it? You have been asked to give the applications, isn't it, to your to, I think so, Ozerde madam, isn't it, for preparing that constitution. So aapki constitution banegi, कौन होगा जनरल सेक्रेटरी, कौन होगा लेडी रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ, who will be the sports in charge, who will be the cultural in charge. So in the similar manner, a constitution hota hai, wo constitution aapko FDO ko submit karna padta hai. Why this is required? If something happens, if something wrong happens, kisko pakadne ka? Okay, who is responsible? Uske liye ye lagta hai constitution. Okay, then you have to give the document which will be showing that this place, this premises is either owned by you or you have rented it from somebody. So, अगर आपने रेंट किया है तो रेंट रिसिप्ट, रेंट एग्रीमेंट वो सब आपको देना पड़ता है, ठीक है? Along with all these documents and many other documents, you have to also submit the these are some of the few documents when you actually go for application of a license. That time some more licenses, some more documents may also be required. Along with that, you have to give an you have to give some affidavits which are issued in form number 32. Okay, so that affidavits also you have to submit. More if you want to read, then if you see over here on the top right hand corner, do read this https-sync.co.in, which talks about the cosmetic licenses. Most of the things are same, some two or three points would be extra. So if you want to manufacture, then first thing that you require is a license, and in order to apply the license, you have to go to the state FDA, you have to fill the application form number 31. You have to pay the required fees, you have to attach the documents to it, you have to attach the affidavits and submit it to them. As soon as you submit it to them, what is going to happen? They are going to appoint a drug inspector. Okay, and that inspector, what is going to do? He is going to visit your premises, he is going to give you the time, and then he is going to come to your premises and he is going to check what all he is going to check. The first thing that he is going to check is whether you have adequate space or not. As I told you, if you don't have adequate space, मैं बोलता हूँ कि मेरे को remdesivir manufacture करना है, ठीक है? क्यों? क्योंकि market में बहुत demand है, बराबर है? बहुत बिकेगा, बहुत पैसा कमाऊंगा मैं. और कहाँ पे मुझे manufacture करना है? मेरे घर के अंदर, जहाँ पे मैं अभी बैठा हूँ, वहाँ पे मुझे manufacture करना है. Will I be given a license? No, definitely not, isn't it? Because I require an adequate space for manufacturing, I require the adequate space for quality control. I require the adequate space for storage of good, packaging material, finished product, barabar, passage, proper passage for movement of the people, proper air conditioning facility, proper air handling facility, proper protection from if there is some fire, etc. So all these things would be required. So the first thing that I would be requiring is I would be requiring the proper space. So the drug inspector is going to check whether I'm having proper space for manufacturing, quality control, storage of raw material, packaging material and finished goods. The second thing that he is going to check is whether I'm having adequate equipment and machinery. As I told you, we are going to talk about equipment and machinery under schedule M in my next lecture. So whether I am having proper adequate machinery and equipment in order to manufacture of cosmetics, that he is going to check. The third thing that he is going to check is whether I am having adequate testing facility to test two things. I have to test the raw material also, whether it is of standard quality or not. That he is going to check whether I am having the testing facility matlab sab aake usme, whether I am having the proper beakers, whether I am having proper machinery, whether I'm having proper equipments, maybe UV, maybe HPTLC, maybe the different packaging material testing ko jom, equipments lagte hai, wo, whether I'm having that or not. Okay. For testing the raw material also and for testing the finished product also. So dono test karne ke liye mere paas equipments hai ki nahi. Apart from that, he is going to check whether I am having proper people. Okay, in order to get the work done from these people, mujhe testing karna hai, mujhe manufacturing karna hai, to iske liye mere paas proper qualified people hai ki. Okay, for that what I require people who are having the proper qualification, maybe diploma in pharmacy, they should be registered pharmacists. Or pehle lagta tha ye, okay, abhi lete nahi koi industry, but science with chemistry as one of the subjects. Learned people are there or not in order to manufacture the things. In short, they are going to look for 5 M's. आपने सुना होगा 5 M's के बारे में. कैन समबडी टेल मी अबाउट व्हाट आर 5 M's इन मैनेजमेंट?
यस सर. मटेरियल
मटेरियल
मनी
मनी फैंटास्टिक.
मशीन
मशीन.
मैन पावर
मैन पावर फैंटास्टिक.
एंड सर लास्ट वन इज आई एम नॉट रिमेम्बरिंग.
मेथड्स
मनी
मेथड्स.
यस सर मेथड्स.
ओके सो यू शुड रिक्वायर प्रॉपर मटेरियल व्हिच यू टॉक्ड इन द फर्स्ट थिंग. ओके सो यू शुड रिक्वायर प्रॉपर मटेरियल. यू शुड रिक्वायर प्रॉपर मेथड्स because you want to convert this material into a finished product. So you require material, you require methods, you require manpower, isn't it, in order to do all these things, right? So you require a machine for converting it, isn't it? And finally is sabke liye aapko kya lagta hai? Aapko lagta hai money iske liye. Theek hai. So मनी एस्पेक्ट तो खैर चेक ही नहीं करेंगे. मनी एस्पेक्ट विल बी अगर आपके पास मशीन है, अगर आपके पास स्पेस है, अगर आपके पास रॉ मटेरियल है, अगर आपने लोगों को अपॉइंट किया है, तो मनी आ जाता है. मनी कैन बी गॉट फ्रॉम द बैंक ऑल्सो. सो लॉट्स ऑफ मनी इज अवेलेबल. यू डोंट हैव टू वरी. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम एंटरप्रेन्योर देन देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ बैंक्स, देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ स्कीम्स दैट आर गोइंग टू हेल्प यू इन ऑर्डर. सो मनी का प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. बाकी 4 M आपके पास है कि नहीं वो आपको देखना है. अगर बाकी 4 M है आपके पास तो आपका यू नो यू कैन स्टार्ट विथ योर ओन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट. राइट. ओके देन द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज द कंडीशनिंग कंडीशंस फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग ऑफ लाइसेंस व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू सी टुमारो. इन दिस व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज वी आर गोइंग टू सी द शेड्यूल M रिक्वायरमेंट. ओके दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी टुमारो. इफ पॉसिबल आई हैव शेयर्ड विथ यू शेड्यूल M. प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट शेड्यूल M. In that, we are going to see the general requirements which comes under Schedule M for manufacturing. Then we are going to see the specific requirements. Just for example, I have taken a few examples. अगर आपको lipstick manufacture करना है तो आपको क्या equipments लगेंगे? अगर आपको hair dye manufacture करना है तो आपको क्या equipments लगेंगे? अगर आपको toothpaste manufacture करना है, tooth powder manufacture करना है तो क्या paste equipments लगेंगे? Okay. So that all comes under Schedule M. I have just taken the 4 examples, that is toothpaste, tooth powders, hair dyes and lipstick. If you see actual Schedule M, there are number of products are given, and for each product what are the equipments that are required that are being given. It doesn't mean that aapko har ek product, like for example if there is a jacketed kettle that is required for lipstick also. And supposing that is required for and that is required for toothpaste also. यहाँ पे भी jacketed kettle है. तो अगर आपको toothpaste और lipstick बनाना है तो आपको 2 jacketed kettle लेने की जरूरत नहीं. एक jacketed kettle होगा तो भी चलेगा, जहाँ पे आप lipstick भी बना सकते हो और आप your toothpaste भी बना सकते हो उसके अंदर. Okay, but these equipments are required if you are intending to manufacture these products. Okay, so list of equipments as I told you is given in under Schedule M2. Under Schedule M you have list of equipments required for manufacturing of drugs. Under Schedule M2 list of equipments for manufacturing of cosmetics is given. And if I am not wrong, under Schedule M3 it is given a list of equipments for manufacturing of your Ayurvedic products. Okay, I think so. Just check it once again. Okay, so please read Schedule M, which we are going to talk about tomorrow. Okay, and then also we are going to talk about the condition of license. We are also going to see Schedule U. Please do go through Schedule U also. Which talks about the records that you have to keep when you are manufacturing a cosmetic products. So you have Schedule U1 that is talks about the manufacturing records, and you have Schedule in second part you have the records that you have to keep for raw material. So records that you have to keep for raw material and the manufacturing records you have to maintain for cosmetic products, that is given under Schedule U1. Okay. So this all we are going to see tomorrow, and then next week again we are going to see the next part, that is the sale and the labeling of cosmetics. Okay. So this is how we are going to go ahead with our syllabus.